What if I told you this tool lets you record podcasts with anyone around the world without losing any video quality, no matter if they have a bad internet connection? And the best part is you can edit your podcast inside of this tool, and they have some advanced AI features which automatically remove all of the silences from your video. With a click of a button, you can change the layout so you can reposition it for social media like TikTok and Instagram, and it also adds captions to your videos. Sounds pretty great, right? Let's check it out. So the tool that I'm talking about is riverside.fm, which you can see on screen right here. So once you go ahead and actually log in, you'll see you're greeted with all of your studios, and you can go ahead and create as many as you like. So for example, let's create a brand new one. You can select your recording type, so audio and video, or only audio. And then you can go ahead and enter your studio. Now, the first thing you'll notice here, which is super important, is you'll be able to select your camera as well as your microphone. And the reason why this is important is because when you actually go ahead and record your episode or podcast, Riverside's gonna record everything locally, which then means if you have bad internet or your host or a guest has bad internet and it starts to buffer and lag, well, you're not actually gonna see that in your recording because it's gonna take your video file and upload that into Riverside so you have the best quality for your video and audio. So let's go ahead and click Join Studio. And the first thing you'll notice is that you'll be able to copy this link where you'll be able to invite all of your guests into your podcast super seamlessly. And of course, you have this big red record button, which means it's going to start recording your podcast as soon as you're ready. Now, before you do this, here are a few handy things you can know before you record. You'll have this script button where you'll be able to input your script, so you can use a teleprompter feature to get your message across. You'll also be able to share your screen right here. You'll have a little chat box here so you can make sure and keep track of what everyone's saying. And this little media button means you can use sound effects like clapping or drum rolls, or even include your intro. So you can use the Riverside one, or you can add your own media. So if you wanted to add different sound effects or intros or outros, you can go ahead and do this here. So once you've pressed record and then you want to end your podcast, you can click on End Studio for All. So if we go ahead and do this, you'll see that we now come to the dashboard. Now, if you've used Riverside in the past, you'll notice that there is actually a new button called Upload, which now means you can upload your past recordings from different podcasts, which is really great because you can utilize all of the Riverside AI features as well as editing features with all of your old podcasts. So let's go ahead and jump into one of these podcast recordings. So here on this dashboard, you'll notice you have a few buttons like Go to Editor, Magic Clips, and Full Episode. One of the new features we've just released is the transcription. So here you'll be able to copy or download the entire transcription of your episode, which is really great just in case you want to find specific parts of your video. The Magic Clips is a fairly new feature which actually uses AI to scan through your entire episode and find clip-worthy videos that you can post on social media. This Full Episode button is a really awesome feature where it actually cleans up your entire episode and gets rid of all of that blank space. It also adds captions and basically makes it into a file which is pretty much ready to share. So we'll go ahead and click on this as well, and you'll see in just a moment it's going to go ahead and give us a clean version of our podcast, which we can see here. You can also see the magic clips have also started to generate, so we'll get quite a few of these. So to give you a demonstration of the magic clips, let's go ahead and click on edit. So notice right off the bat, it's transformed it into a 9:16 aspect ratio, which you can of course change to 1:1 or 16:9. But you also see that you have the transcription section here, which you can actually go ahead and highlight, and then you can remove it, or you can create a clip, which is really handy. So you can see it's instantly just trimmed this from the video. But you'll also notice some of these buttons up here. So for instance, layout allows you to change the layout slightly, so you can keep the aspect ratio, you can give it round corners, or you can make it a full frame. But then you also have the option to add different backgrounds. So for example, if we change this to keep aspect ratio, you can see that we've got all of these different backgrounds, which is also amazing. And of course, you can see that we have these captions here, so you can edit them right here. You can change all of these different styles and even change the font, and then add different sizes as well as colors, and even change the orientation of where you want your captions. You also have the option to add a logo. So for example, I've just put a profile picture up here, which you can of course resize or reposition wherever you like.
And then once you're happy, you can go ahead and press export and then select whichever options you want, change it to 4K, press export, and then you'll have a ready to use clip to post on social media. Now heading back to the dashboard, we can see that the full episode feature has now been finished. So it's transformed it from a 30 minute clip into a 26 minute clip. So let's go ahead and click on edit, and you can see what it's done here is basically removed all of the blanks. So we can zoom into the timeline and you can see it's just cut out all of that blank space right there, which is really awesome. So in the editor, what you can do is just trim it the original way or the manual way like this. But again, you can click on the transcript button and do the exact same thing where you highlight what you want, and then you can go ahead and remove it. Another great feature is you'll see right here we have a search button, and because we've got the transcription, we can actually go ahead and type in whatever we want. So for example, sound, and what that's gonna do is highlight all of the places where I've said the word sound or Ben said the word sound, so we can easily find them in our video. So a really handy feature that no other tool is offering. And of course, you'll have all of the handy features that I showed you within Magic Clips. So you can, of course, toggle this on if you want to remove all the silences. You can change your layouts, add backgrounds, and of course, add captions to your videos, which is super handy because you can go ahead and customize them to however you want. And once you're happy with your podcast, go ahead and click on export, select the video quality you want, toggle on these parameters if you want them, press export, and in just a few minutes, your podcast is gonna be ready for you to download, and you can go ahead and upload that onto social media. And now you know why this tool is the best tool to start recording your podcast. I hope you guys did enjoy this video, and if you haven't already, be sure to check out Riverside today. Like I said and mentioned, they have some awesome features so you can record and edit your podcast super easily. I hope you guys did enjoy this video, and if you did, smash that like button and subscribe if you haven't already, and I'll see you in the next video.